when you're giving a talk, it is never about you, it's always about your audience. Who am I having a conversation with? You know, who am I speaking with?
The more that I can find out about an audience, the more I can tailor the message that I have to the people that are going to be there. The first thing you can do is just ask.
Is this an international conference?
Are they other researchers?
Do they want to learn new techniques?
Are they students?
Do they like sports? Maybe I can make a college football reference. Are they there because they have to be and they don't want to be there? Those I find the most fun talks because you have to really engage an audience who doesn't want to listen to you. The more information I have about my audience, the better I'm going to be able to tailor what I am going to say so that it can connect with their previous knowledge, with their experiences, and with who they are. You have to look at your research from your audience perspective.
You want to emphasize and highlight the parts of your research that are going to connect with them. Maybe you have a phylogenetic tree in one that is especially interesting to evolutionary biologists. But if you're talking to a molecular geneticist, you might want to, you know, forget about the phylogenetic tree because you're going to have to explain what it is and all the things behind it and its significance. But maybe you want to do an experiment where you swapped out some genes and saw what the phenotype was. That's something that they can connect to. You're emphasizing very different aspects so that they can connect to the work and see the relevance to them.
You need to know how familiar they are with your area of research. You need to understand what you might need to define. So I think there's a big misconception in assuming that the audience knows more than they do. For example, I worked with microtubules, which is a part of something called the cytoskeleton, but I couldn't tell you like in-depth stuff about actin, which is another part of the cytoskeleton, even though people would say we're in the same field. So if I went to a talk about actin, I'd really need to have a lot of introduction to understand what the person was looking at and why they thought it was important.
You could have an audience that has scientists, you know, in an entirely different field from you. And so you can't make the assumption that they understand certain jargon that especially is specific to your own field or subfield. What is the background information that my audience really needs to understand the research and the field behind the work that I've done, as well as the individual experiments themselves?
By determining who your audience is, you will be able to tell how much information you want to include in your talk, whether it's in the introduction or the body of your talk.
I also think about my audience, you know, in using different stylistic features of an introduction, especially like a hook, for example. When I'm trying to tell a story to make the subjects that I'm conveying more relatable.
I could give an analogy about like the Golden Gate Bridge, you know, like bridging two parts of the Bay Area. This talks to me, this talks to everyone else living in the Bay Area, but it might not talk to someone that lives in Paris. You need to think about tailoring your analogies to your audience.
I think a really big part of giving a good talk is just being able to relate to the people that are there. And in order to do that, I want to sort of know who the audience is.